Well, I want to talk to you today, and I want to tell you a secret that we can travel in a way, indirectly, we can travel back in time. What you're going to see here with me here today, behind me, is a scroll. Okay? Specifically, we call it in Hebrew, we call it a Torah scroll. Remember the story with Moses, the Ten Commandments, right? When he came down, remember, God gave him the second commandments, the second tablet, set of tablets. And God tell him to write also later on, write everything. Write everything I tell you, right? Now, what do you think he wrote it on? How do you think Moses wrote it?
God wrote it.
Well, Moses wrote them. How do you think Moses wrote them? How do you think God wrote them? On what?
Tablets.
Yeah, but then he tell him, write everything. Write everything.
Stones?
On the ground?
On ground?
Yeah.
On scroll. He wrote it on a scroll. Now, what do you think the scrolls is made up of?
Stone. Paper.
We're going to play a little game. Whoever get the most answer right, going to get some sort of reward here. Okay? What do you think this the scroll is written on? Yes.
Cloth?
No. Parchment? No.
Maybe wool?
Wool? No. I need two brave volunteers. Volunteer. You're in the corner. You're in the corner. Come on. I volunteered you. You're enlisted. I'm telling you, whoever sit down, go and be volunteer today. Come. Another volunteer. You, sitting down, come. Come, quickly. Messiah will already come. Come. Now, you come around. What's your name? Nicole and?
Bernanchi's?
Uh-huh. Okay, I want you. Oh, smile. He's already getting it. Get excited, boy. We'll see. Now, I want you to touch this. Tell me what you think it feel like. Some construction paper? What do you think it feel like, Nicole?
Like a poster board.
Do you think it's paper? You don't think it's paper. So give me your wildest guess. You have one guess. What is this made of?
Somebody say elephant skin.
Elephant skin. Who said the elephant skin? I like your sense of humor. You're getting close, but it's not an elephant skin, but you're getting closer. Anybody? What? It is made out of some sort of skin. Thanks, guys. You can go back to your seat for a second. Give yourself a little of this. Do a little of this as this. You got 1 point there. Stay in the game. You might actually win something today. Goat skin is one of the skins that this can be on. Anybody guess any other skin this can be on?
Lamb skin.
Give yourself another one of those. You got a point too. Any other skin?
Llama.
No. You're wild on me there. What? No, it's not a horse or a donkey or an elephant.
Cow.
Give yourself a little bit of that. So we say cow, we say goat, we say sheep. Now, let me ask you a question. What about pigskin? Who do you think pigskin? Now, wait a second. Are Jewish people allowed to eat pig? So it's a little strange that God says right on pigskin. Of course not pigskin. No pigskin. It was a joke. But give yourself a little pet anyway. Now, two questions I have for you. Let's see who got it right. Why do you think that Moses would ride it on an animal skin? Really?
He didn't have paper?
Think about this for a second. Guess.
So it could last longer.
You are on a roll there. What is up with this? We have a biblical scholar there. Give yourself another one of those. You are correct. The reason, one of the reasons that God says to Moses to write it on one of those animal skins is so it can last longer. You want to guess how old is this particular scroll?
Like 2,000 years.
Come on, let's be realistic.
Millions.
We're getting a little wild, guys. By the way, did I forget to tell you, all of you are going to be very famous on YouTube. So evaluate your question and answer. We're going to see you all on YouTube, so.
Infinity.
No, realistically.
10.
No.
Ready?
I will help you. It's something between 0 and 2,000.
Oh, wait.
A couple of hundred. This particular scroll is 200 years old, between 200 and 300 years old. The oldest scroll in the world actually found in Jerusalem, it's about 1,100 years old. After about 300-400 years old, it started to fall apart, this particular skin. But it's in order to make this skin writable on, they had to put it in a special acid. It's like a vinegar to make it preserve. You see, that's why you say it's feel like a paper, kind of a paper, a hard paper, like a poster. This is extremely, extremely durable. So one of the reasons that God says to Moses to write it upon this is so it can last, so the word of God can last. But there is another reason. Anybody want to come with a bigger and a deeper reason why God says write it upon an animal skin? Yes. Oh, you give yourself not one, but this. Can you do that? Two. You got a two-pointer. This is a big one. Guys, pay attention. This is a big one. In order for this word to be written, an animal has to give its own life. Do you realize? There is a rule in the Bible. Just go like that. You ready? Somebody have to die. I know it doesn't sound good, but it's true. Life for life. Remember the story of the garden? Adam and Eve.
Yeah.
You know the story of Adam and Eve? Yes. God tell them you can eat from everything, right?
Yes. God says in the beginning, God says that they could eat from any tree they want except for the tree of knowledge.
Give it to us.
Good and evil.
You got it.
And all of a sudden, this serpent says to Eve.
Give it to us. Listen.
Did God really tell you not to eat from the tree of life? then the serpent tempted Eve to eat from the tree, and she ate from the tree,
then
gave it to her husband and said that this will also make you wise. But then they knew what they'd done, so they recognized that they were all naked.
Give me the bottom line. What happened in there? Did they eat?
Yes, they did.
Okay, that's the bottom line. They messed up. They ate. Okay, what's your name?
Ron,
give yourself this. Sit down, Ron. That's good. Now, let me ask you, though, a question. They ate, and God says, if you eat, you're going to do what? You're going
die.
To... Did they die?
No.
Well, yeah, eventually we're all going to go, but did they went right there? So what? Wait a second. If God says they're going to die, and they ate from it and they didn't die, how come? This is not a Bible class, by the way, but I'm curious now. What's the answer? How come? Yeah.
They lost their immortality.
Okay, but they're still not dead. They're still alive.
They died spiritually. They lost their connection with God.
I don't think that's the answer. The answer is what the Bible says. It says, before he escorted them out of the garden, then he made them a garment.
A garment?
A garment from what?
An
animal skin. Why? Because God made a substitution to Adam and Eve. Somebody had to die in order for Adam and Eve to be spared. That is the right answer. Do you realize that an animal had to die in order for us to read what is inside? This is important. This particular scroll, any scroll, is read once a week in a synagogue. in synagogues all over the world from the very first five book of Moses. And let me show you today how it would do. We're going to reenact it. I need a very strong actor. Somebody here enacting?
I like
acting. What did I say? I need, first of all, somebody really good looking. He's good looking. Come on. He's good looking. What's your name?
Scotty,
you are actually going to be today our Torah reader. Okay. Woo! Give it to Scotty. Give it to him. Now we're going to transfer you to be Jewish for a moment. Yeah. Not too many Jewish blondes, but it's will work. Now, you look very handsome already. Well, that's much your eye colors even. Look at that. This is called the robe. Imagine we are now 2,000 years ago in the temple. We are in the temple. Here is a Saturday in a temple. I want you to understand this is not an object. It's much more than an object. Here's the way this would be used 2,000 years ago. Okay, here you go. Let me say over you the blessing. Amen. Say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Very good. All right. Now I need your help. We're not done. We need a couple more. You know another good-looking fellow that can be kind of like your minion? We need a minion.
Benachi
again? Oh, boy. Benachi, you're a minion. You have one little job. Come here. Come. Hey, by the way, high priest, you come here to the reader. Benachi, you're going to be our, this, whatever this is, the holder of this. Don't mess with this yet. Now, we also need four other good-looking guys or girls. Good-looking, I said? Good-looking? No. That are strong. We need some strong ones here. It's not rocket science. Come on. The service is already over. Well, you're his minion, so technically he gave you the job. So you pick two, he pick two. Come on. Oh, good one. Come on. He got you on that one. All right, you go around.
Okay, Amber.
Three. Okay, those who are being picked, I want you here. Those three. Okay, come. Four of you here. Now, you have to understand. Come. I'm going to uncover the scroll for a second. This scroll was read from every Saturday. Notice when you read your Bible, right, you see chapter 1, chapter 2, period, verse 1, verse 2. Do you notice, where's the verse numbers here? Do you see verse numbers? Do you see chapter number?
No.
There is none of that. So one of the first things I want you to recognize, whoever wrote the scroll, the idea, you know, when we read our, here you go, here's my Bible, chapter 1, chapter 2, all of this came much, much later, hundreds and years later. There's no chapter break. There's really not even period in these things, okay? Now, every Saturday, the owner, he's called the owner of the
scroll.
Owner of the Torah, the word Torah. By the way, anybody know what the word Torah means?
Bible? Yeah.
No. Torah. The word Torah is usually translated as the word law. Everybody heard about the law? The law of Moses? But I'm going to tell you a secret. Are you ready to a little secret? The word Torah doesn't mean law. It's mean to parent. Ooh. Why? Because what a good dad does when you have children, he parent them. He give them some guidelines. That's what a good dad and mom do. They parent the children. So this is literally called what we call the law. I want you to think about this. It's the book of parenting, right? The book of parenting. So it have a lot of guidelines and principles for us today. And today we're going to read. We're going to assume you're all the synagogue for second century. You are in the synagogue, okay? And here we are, I have our crews and our minions, and they're ready to do our little service. So the very first thing they would have done, you would have the hand carrier right there. Where's the hand? There we go. Come. He almost ran away from that. The hand is known by the name of Yad. Now, do you think we are allowed to touch it? No. We don't allow to touch it because it represents God's holy word. So there was one person who was the hand bearer, and his job was to hand it to the reader. Okay? Come. Give it to him. By the way, I need one more.
This thing's heavy.
Yeah, it is heavy. Usually it would have been made out of real gold. This is not real gold, by the way. One more. Come, one more. Jonathan. Okay? So, wait. We need one more. One more. All of you are going to take part of this play, I see. You pick.
Oh,
okay. Okie dokie. So your two jobs, wait, you come. Those two are your witnesses. Now listen to me. Here's the way it will work out. Let's say you read something. Have you ever read in English? And you misread a word?
Yeah.
Happened. Here's the way it's happened with the scroll. If somebody misread a word, those two witnesses have to say, stop, reread the word. Reread it again. Each word and each letter is so important that even if you mess up one letter, stop. The reading stop. We correct the word and we go back. So you can imagine it could take several hours, right? But we have 5 minutes, so we will reenact it. So your job is as the two witnesses to make sure that he doesn't mess up. Well, he doesn't know Hebrew, right? I feel sorry for him. He's going to learn Hebrew right now. You're going to learn it with me, okay?
All right,
we're going to learn it. So here's your job of the four strong people and good-looking people that we pick. Two good-looking people, come here. Two of you here. Two of you in the back. Good looking. You're good looking. Good looking. Now look at what they had to do. Do you think that they can read wherever they feel like it?
No.
Remember the story about Jesus walking into the synagogue on Sabbath and they handed the scroll of Isaiah? And Jesus says, wow, this four scrolls speak about me. Remember that? He said, this is about me. Do you think Jesus could read wherever he feel like? No, there is a portion every week, and somebody had to call him up to read it. He cannot just, your name is Scotty, right? Scott just cannot just show up and say, I want to read this because this speak about me. He cannot do that. Somebody have to call you, and somebody have to point you to somewhere. So today I'm going to call you. What's the name of your dad, your father?
Doc. Yeah.
Deal. So here's the way it would work out. I would say in Hebrew, Yahamod Scotty Ben Doc La Torah, which means, here comes Scott, son of Doc, to the law. Somebody has to call him up. So you're called up now to face God, okay? The two witnesses watching you, you're going to read Hebrew now. You're going to do Hebrew with us. Now your job is come with me. We're going to unscroll it to the portion. We're going to pick a portion for today. We're going to pick the Ten Commandments for a moment. Okay? Hand here. And when I say 1, 2, 3, very carefully, no violence, okay? We're going to go this way. Okay? Slowly.
Right.
Slowly. Keep it going. Keep it coming. Stop. Good. Now, notice, where's our reader? Come, reader. Notice, like here, you see there's no really spaces, right? Mm-hmm. There's no spaces. All of a sudden, right here, you notice all this white space? Mm-hmm. What do you think there is a white space here? What do you think the reason for white space? If you have a book, and you read a book, and all of a sudden somebody put a huge white space, what do you think it means? Say it again.
They're out of things to say in that particular section.
Out of things to say?
In that particular section.
Okay, that's maybe one theory. Anybody have another risk theory? If I read a paragraph and then I say blank. New chapter. Now, usually when you're in the end of the chapter, you read it, right? It's pretty important. So maybe what the author is trying to tell us is, and it's not that it's a paragraph, he gives us four words. Look, one, two, two words, not a sentence even, and he says huge space. Four words, huge space. Maybe trying to tell us, pay close attention. Maybe really it's the exact opposite and running out of words to say. And he's saying, I'm going to give you only two words. And I want you to stop and think about those two words. Because those two words are really important. Okay? So really, in essence, it's really cool. Because in the Ten Commandments, what you see, he gives us each commandment, huge space. Each commandment, huge space. He said, think about it. 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 And here it's the way it will be sound. Scott going to learn a crash course in Hebrew with me, okay? Right. So here we go. Where's the hand holder? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. You're going to hold the hand right here. Okay, Scott. And now pay attention. If you make a mistake in Hebrew, you stop him, okay?
Wait,
I'm kidding.
No,
you don't stop. You shout, stop.
Okay.
And then you say, hey, let's say you made a mistake. Here, I'll show you.
Okay.
Let's say, say with me. Shh, shh, shh. Oh, by the way, the rest of the people would have to stand up. So stand up for a moment. Stand up, stand up, stand up. Just for a moment. I have you standing up out of respect to the Lord. And you would say with me, Scott, but you have to be loud and strong. Say, lo,
lo,
tirzach,
tirzach.
Uh-oh. Mistake. Stop.
Stop. You
stop.
Clear your throat. Whoa, 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 whoa. We have to help him. Clear your throat. Can you do? There you go. That's good. Like you clean. Tirzach.
Tirzach.
There you go. Here we go. Here we go. He's getting it. He's getting it. Let's try it again. Lo.
Lo.
Tirzach.
Tirzach.
There you go. Then you go to the next one. Lo. By the way, lo mean, it doesn't say don't. It means in Hebrew, don't do it. Don't do it. So the first thing he says to us, do not kill. Do not murder. Don't murder. Don't worry, okay? So you see the word lo in Hebrew mean don't. The next, second thing, here you go, the hand, perfect. Say lo,
lo,
tin af.
Tin af.
Listen, that was good. That was good. You're natural. Then the next thing, you're moving. Here you go, right here. Lo.
Lo.
Tignov.
Tignov.
Don't steal. Don't do it. And then it says, let's go up a little bit. Say with me, kabed.
Kabed.
Et.
Ed.
Et.
Et.
Et. There you go. Et. Move. You keep on moving with us. Avicha.
Avicha.
Ve'et.
Ve'et.
Imecha.
Imecha.
Lema'an.
Lema'an.
Ya'arichun. Ya'arichun.
Ya'arichun.
Yamecha.
Yamecha.
Al.
Al.
Adama.
Adama.
Honor your father and your mother. So your days on the earth here will be prolonged. Okay, and then they kept on writing it. And then something would have happened. You ready? Not only that it was held, because the word says faith come by hearing, we had to do something special. Now is the really strong and good-looking people coming to play, okay? All right, I'm taking. But you're strong, you look strong, and we need stable. This is a sensitive part. Come, come here. You're going to have the most important part. You hold it, and you're the tallest. It's perfect. We have to. The Torah was read in the temple like that. They read the entire thing. By the way, great job. And then they lift it up to exalt God, and they point with the pointer to exactly when everybody read, and everybody look at that and point their finger and said, we read from here, and here, we're going to do it together. Here's the way it was done. So here we go. Hold it here. Hold it here. We're going to have to be, hold it. You get ready. We're going to get it vertically up, okay? Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Slowly, slowly. Two hands, sweetie. There we go. Slowly. Higher. Higher. Come on. Put some muscle.
Oh my God.
come on, come on, help her, she's losing it. I said I need strong people, what are you doing to me? Okay, here we go, where's the hand? You see, we read, well, don't breathe. If you go down, we're all going down with you, just hold it. You see, right here, everybody take your hand, and you point there. And we would sing this song that go like this in Hebrew. Vazot HaTorah Asher Sam Moshe Lifnei Bnei Yisrael Al Pi Adonai Eyad Moshe. And everybody would say hallelujah, hey, oh, hey. Everybody would be excited, and then they would put it down. Then they would put it down, and they would do that, and they would have read the entire Word of God in such a fashion. Why do you think it was exalted? Because they wanted everybody to know that the Word of God has been heard in the place. Give all our volunteers a hand. And have a seat. We are almost done. But now I want to show you a clue. Okay? I see you're becoming quite comfortable with all of this. That's cool. All right. Stick around here for a second. And your minion can stay here for a second too, because he's a good help. So, anybody here was born in a, I asked the question earlier in the other group, but I don't think I asked you. Anybody was born in any place except America? Except the United States?
I was not born in Kansas.
What?
I was born in Kansas City.
Okay. Well, yes. Kansas City. Okay, but that's okay. It's well. Okay, wait a second. You were born in Kansas City, Missouri. Hold on. You have a different accent. You don't sound like a Texan. Anybody else here have a different accent, even if you're born in America? Can you do a different accent? Come. Let's see how good you are.
Which one do you want to do?
What can you do?
You can do a lot of accents.
Can you do a little Russian accent, speaking English?
Maybe I can do a little Russian, maybe.
What about a Spanish speaker who...
Maybe I could do a little Spanish.
Okay.
Just did that bit.
A little bit. Any other? Can you do a German to try to speak English?
Oh, you see, German Volkswagens are the best. Those dumb Americans, they don't know how to make cars.
You're good, so you stick around there. Any other one?
Tell me which one to do, maybe I can do it.
Can you try to do one on Middle Eastern? That's a hard one.
It is a hard one.
What about Irish?
Well, maybe I can do a bit of a wee Irish one.
Okay, do you notice that you have an accent when he put the accent? I want you to think about the scroll for a second that Scott read from. Based on the letters, we know which accent it has. Different scroll have a different accent, right? In the same way that if you would write a story, let's say you would write a novel, right? You put your own style into it, right? Your own spin into it. And if he writes here, he will put his own spin. The same thing is true of the scroll. Now, if I took two scrolls, and let's say one letter is off, one letter, do you think I can use the both scrolls? The answer is no. They have to be identical. Even if one letter is off, it has to go to a place where it's called a gniza. It's a graveyard of scrolls. Basically, it cannot be used. Why? Because the Word of God says you are not to add or to subtract from the Word of God. So that is impossible. However, what about the accents? I want you to pay close attention to something. Let's pick a letter here. Come with the accents. The accents, man. Do you see this letter here? The middle one there? Where's the hand? Where's the hand barrier? Come. Let's say we're going to pick a letter here. Thou shall not murder. By the way, it's necessary to say thou shall not kill, thou shall not murder. And you see right there, do you see those funny three lines above the letter? 1, 2, 3. Do you see three lines there?
Yeah.
Do you guys see that?
Yeah.
Those three lines, they look like three spiky lines, have nothing to do with the lettering. It have to do with the accents. In essence, whoever wrote to us wanted to tell us, pay close attention to this letter in this word. And each one of those represent a different way to sing it, because this is all a song. In essence, it's all a song. And he says, pay close attention to this letter in this verse. For instance, when you write a scroll, notice all the letters. Do you notice all the letters look the same? Right? They're pretty much, in order to make a what's known a perfect scroll that can be used, all the letters have to be the same. There is one place in the Bible, though, it's a special place where the letter look a little bit different. One word in one chapter. Anybody want to take a wild guess in the first five books of Moses? If you can guess that, you're getting... Do you want me to tell you? I'll tell you. In Deuteronomy 6:4, actually, let's go to Jesus' word. A man came to Jesus and says to Jesus, Jesus, tell me, what is the greatest commandment?
Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul.
All right, cool. You got it. You know your Bible. I love it. I love it. I love it. Give yourself a tap. Now, tell me, where Jesus reading from?
Jesus is reading from Deuteronomy.
Thank you very much. He's reading from Deuteronomy 6:4. It's the basis for the entire Word of God. So when you go to this word, hear, O Israel, when you start the scriptures, hear, O Israel, the word there, hear, you see it in the scroll, it is extended like that. A full line, just one word. Why? There is a specific here there is a specific word that the author wanted to stretch to us. Remember, a man, Jesus, there's a famous sermon, it's called Sermon of the Mount, and in the Sermon of the Mount, Jesus says you are to observe all of this commandment, every jot and every tittle, right? Come, you see this? You see those three lines? Those is what's called tittle. That's what Jesus referred to. That is a tittle of the Torah. What does it mean? It is the flair. He said, you are not just to do things because I said to you, do them with the right, what?
Attitude.
With the right attitude. You see, it's not just about doing it, it's about doing things with the right motivation, with the right heart. That's what Jesus was saying. And matter of fact, there are 22 Hebrew letters. Some of them are huge, and some of them are tiny. The smallest Hebrew letter is this. Do you see this?
Yeah.
This one, it's tiny, right? Anybody ever had a thorn go into them?
No.
Never? Like a little tiny thorn, you know, like you sit and you have a thorn going into you.
Splinter.
Like a splinter. Is it hard to get the splinter out?
Yeah.
Why is it hard to get it out?
So
it is so small. So when Jesus says every jot is important, come. Do you see this letter again?
Yeah.
You see the spike here in the end? You almost need a magnifying glass, right?
Yeah.
That is called a jot. That's what it is. So in essence, what Jesus said to us, it's important to us to do things in the right motivation, but also to pay attention to the splinter, to even the smallest of things. Even the smallest of things that is written is still important for us today. So when we read the Word of God, we need to pay attention to everything that is written. Nothing was given without a purpose. That was Jesus' point, even in the scroll itself. So anyway, thanks, guys. I really appreciate you guys did a great, great job. And I know we are running out of time. Thank you.